Good morning. I am Julia Sleezer. I'm joined here by
River Rain.
And you are watching the 2018 Wftda European Continental Cup live from Telford, UK. Brought to you by the Birmingham Blitz Dames and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. So today we're going to be seeing Kallio from Helsinki, Finland, facing off against Tiger Bay from Cardiff, Wales. Kallio comes in as our number one seed, and they are ranked 46 currently in the WFTDA, and Tiger Bay are our fourth seed, ranked number 49th in the WFTDA. So would you like to start off with the Kallio rosters?
Yes, I would. So Kallio will be playing in white today, and on their roster we have 103 Bela Glukosi, 113 L, 19 Katti Schrödinger, 2 Aika Helppo, 234 Edgehog, 27 Yi Karpov, 3 Kutti, 410 Vattu Vimma, 49 is Macho Bichu, 60 is KO, 777 Gilbert, 872 Laura Pönkkanen, and 911 Ikonen.
And for Tiger Bay, which will be playing in black with orange accents, we have 10 Top Gurn, 147 Nitrogen, 15 Dos Santos, 19 Steph Howarth, 271 Peb, 31 Plant, 316 Thrill Collins, 40 Kid Block, 44 Billy Pistol, 453 Attila Lahan, 59 Wild, 6 Chant Hell, 62 Pip Gray, 81 Angie, and 88 Kemp.
So there you have it. The winner of this game goes on to the final. And that will be at the last game tonight at 5:30, local time. The loser of this game will play the game right before that, which is the third and fourth place game, at 3:30 local time. So please check your time conversions for when that will be in your area, because we have had to turn the clocks 1 hour back this night, which was a delightful extra hour of sleep. if you did not do that, please check a time conversion to make sure that you are getting the right times. And we've got about 10 seconds to derby. So let's jump right into it.
All right. So first out, we have Gilbert for Kallio facing off against Steph Howarth from Tiger Bay.
And that was a penalty whistle straight off the bat to Bela Glukosi from Kallio.
And it is going to be Tiger Bay taking lead, edging away on the inside. Gilbert still trying to find their way through the pack. The initial pass is now complete by Gilbert. The first scoring pass for Steph Howarth is still incomplete. She does call it off from the middle of the pack. It is going to be the full 5 points.
Both teams with one blocker apiece in the box. Oh, and as I speak, I see that the Kallio pivot L is also sent to the box. So pack advantage for next jam goes to Tiger Bay.
Angie is going to be taking the line for Tiger Bay, and that is Yi Karpov for Kallio. Bela Glukosi back in play now, trying to help their teammate out. Tiger Bay absolutely ferocious in this first game of the day. Immediately bringing back to that three wall up front, the pack surrounding the pivot line right now. Yi Karpov is absolutely stunted in the back right now. Angie up front, finding herself in a similar situation. Nearly blocked out to the outside. Now she's through. Tiger Bay takes lead. 2 out of 2 jams in this game. About 5 feet behind her, though, Yi Karpov is probably going to force this call off pretty quickly. Yep, coming in backwards. That was a 0-2 in favor of Tiger Bay. Right now, Kallio has not put any points on the board just yet. Tiger Bay was 7. Let's watch a replay of lead obtained there.
Yeah, Bella Glucosi was a showmanship performance of one-on-one blocking up in front. Oh, look at the jammers trying to duel each other. That is Gilbert and Kid Block.
Pack a bit sped up this time through. Gilbert up at the top of the pack. Looks like they are going to make it out and pick up lead. The pack stays with them, nearly swallowing them up. Kid Block also up front, temporarily taking the offensive. Now back in the jammer position. Gilbert's going to go ahead and call that off.
That was an excellent like jammer to blocker switch by Kid Block, going into play defensively so that her teammates can absorb Gilbert back into the pack.
Right.
That was a beautiful executed. And we see it now. No, just cut short on the replay.
Plant out for Tiger Bay is going to be facing off against Ikonen. Ooh, ah, all right. Huge hit to the outside. Takes Plant down. Ikonen also is recycled back about the same time. Both of them are re-entering the pack from a pack starting position, frankly. Ikonen is up front trying to bash through the front wall.
Has been declared lead, though, it looks like. And then reabsorbed by the Tiger Bay defense.
Finally, out of the fray, Ikonen will be coming in on their first scoring pass shortly. Star in hand, Plant is through, initial is completed. And the jam is called. Three more points, the first 3 points for Kallio picked up. Tiger Bay is still sitting at 7. 25 and a half minutes left in the half.
So that was 3 lead jams in a row for Tiger Bay before Kallio was allowed a single one. But if you look at the rankings, I mean, these two teams are so close together that this game could potentially go either way.
Sure. Gilbert facing off against Steph Howarth. We have an empty penalty box. So we'll see everyone in play. Lead has been awarded again to Gilbert. The pack is still behind the pivot line, just now getting around to turn one. Gilbert comes in. It is blocked out and back by number 62. That is Pip Gray. And it's going to be recycled. Or I suppose we're going to...
We're going to kill that time right there.
Yeah.
Yep. Tiger Bay with 2 blockers in the box. So...
Why not?
That killing of the time is not a bad move.
Sure.
Multiplayer penalties being assessed to another Tiger Bay blocker.
As number 15 re-enters play, she has a seat. The pack swimming around between terms 1 and 2. In the meantime, Gilbert coming through and picking up another 5 points for Kallio.
And that is a lead change.
It's true. By 1 point, Gilbert coming in for the second scoring pass. Pack all but at a standstill, now gaining movement as Gilbert comes through, completing that second scoring pass. Another 5 points. Right now, a 10-point jam in favor of Helsinki's Kallio. Once again, star in hand. That is completed by Tiger Bay at initial, but there's not enough leeway allowed for any points to be picked up. So it was 4 points on that last pass, a 14-point jam for Kallio, 17-7, 23 minutes left in the half.
And as we've seen at the moment, Tiger Bay is having some blocker penalty issues with pretty much everybody on that previous line rotating in and out of the penalty box. Two blockers currently in the box. So pack advantage to Kallio, which also means Yi Karpo is first out of the pack to pick up lead.
Kid block still trying to get through. We see once again Kid kind of taking the offensive position as the opposing jammer comes through. Yikarvo through for 5 points. It looks like Kallio has developed a strategy very early in this game that's working for them. Kid block is out and would have been in scoring position just a little time after that fourth whistle. So nothing picked up once again for Tiger Bay Brawlers. A 5 point jam for Kallio, 22-7.
That's the fourth time in a row Kallio picks up lead so far. They've held Tiger Bay scoreless since jam two.
Got the countdown going, empty penalty box. Once again, Ikinen versus Billy Pistol. Billy Pistol being recycled back. Kallio behind the jammer line. All four of them three of them concentrated on keeping that jammer back. Number 88 from Tiger Bay, Kemp, trying to help her teammate get through. Lead has been awarded to Ikinen, and Billy Pistol is out. Ikinen gets re-swallowed into the pack. It was on her first scoring pass, but pulled back into the pack because it has calls it off with 4 points before Billy Pistol could pick any up.
So we are going to use this little team timeout for Tiger Bay to talk to you about the bracket challenge by Derby on Toast. You can still get your predictions in for the WFTDA championships, and you could win a trolley gear bag from Adam Skates. So if that is something you are into, go visit derbyontoast.com to make your predictions now. And for those of you with brackets still intact, congratulations. And if you want to join in on the conversation today and the rest of the day, talk to us at #talk2WFTDA on Twitter. If you want to send us your cats, you can also do that. That is on #catsofWFTDA.
No pressure.
Please show us your cats.
So we'll be starting off this next jam in just a few seconds. We have one Tiger Bay blocker in the box. That is Pip Gray. Number 19 is going to be jamming. Steph Howard facing off against 777 Gilbert. Each team with mirrored three walls. We have sort of a bridge. Yeah, there we go. All right, and out is Gilbert.
Yeah, Tiger Bay loses another blocker to the box. So we only have two defenders for Tiger Bay to try and stop Sarah Gilbert, and Sarah Gilbert does short work of that and sweeps through for five more.
Gilbert coming through, second scoring pass is another 5 points, so 10 points right now on this jam. Coming in for their third scoring pass and hung up on Tiger Bay's defenses towards the back. It may take a little more active blocking than is being provided right now to help them get through. In the meantime, Steph Howarth is out. It did take a minute 15 or so to get there. Four more points on that pass for Kallio, 40-7. Now under 20 minutes and a half.
Again, this is, how many is that? Six jams in a row. Kallio has taken lead and held Tiger Bay scoreless.
Nice.
So what we are looking for right now is when that streak breaks. Will it break? Who knows?
Yikarpo and Angie out jamming. One Tiger Bay blocker in the box, and is going to be Yikarpo taking lead.
It's a four-on penalty being issued, and that's going to go to a Kallio blocker.
Absolutely having to mash her way through. That is Angie coming out, having completed her initial. In the meantime, Yikarpo coming through for another scoring pass for her team. That is five more points, so 45-7.
Well, we started out with a strong show from Tiger Bay, but yeah. Kallio has just been dominating the past that's seven jams now. And for teams that are this close in WFTDA rankings, it's quite an interesting show of strength from Kallio. They're coming in, showing why they are seeded number one.
Definitely. Kid Block absolutely leaning full weight against this front wall of all colors. Ukinen also getting a run for their money in the back, but it is going to be Tiger Bay awarded lead for the first time, and you say six jams, is it?
Seven. Now. Yeah.
That's how.
Streak is broken. Let's see if Kid Block can pick up some points. It's going to be the first point since jam number two for Tiger Bay.
Kid Block calling it off. Let's see what we got.
Two more.
All right. So now 45-9.
We've got some penalties accumulating by now. Definitely blocker penalties seem to be a thing for Tiger Bay at the moment, which is consistent with what we have from their 2018 season statistics.
Gilbert and Steph Howard going to start off this jam. Ooh, looked like Steph was going to find passage, but the all colors not interested in letting her go just yet. That is KO up front, along with her teammates. Steph Howarth takes lead, but hot on her heels is Gilbert. The pack now at a pretty good clip. Steph Howarth coming in, firstly, going up against number 19, Katy Schrodinger. Going to be, I believe, a 0-0. Yes, a 0-0 jam.
So that's second jam with nobody scoring so far. We've got 16 minutes left on the clock of this first half.
You've seen this replay of obtaining lead, just an absolute challenge. Yikarpo facing off against Plant. Already a penalty awarded to Plant, so it's going to be lead open and a power start for Yikarpo. Lead is awarded to Kallio. The pack is stood around turn one. Yikarpo comes in just now for their first scoring pass. Your teammates breaking up any sort of defensive structure Tiger Bay might have in store. That is through, and another 5 points on the board, courtesy of Yikarpo.
We're all but stopped here going into the second apex. But that is Karpov escaping with 5 points.
Coming in for their third scoring pass. Ooh, she ducked down. I thought she was going to make it on the outside. Not quite. The crowd is absolutely going wild. Plant has come out of the box several seconds ago, has come through, and will be on her first scoring pass if the whistles hadn't happened. So there was three more points for Kallio, picking up 13 total for the jam, bringing him up to 58. Tiger Bay at 9, about 14 and a half minutes left in the half.
So if you're looking at this tournament and are interested in being a part of this, come work with the WFTDA. Visit WFTDA.com and click the links for Continental Cups or recognized tournaments to host one of your own.
Billy Pistol out for Tiger Bay. Eakin in for Kallio. Both of them, again, hung up on these excellent defenses both teams have been providing. Lots of whistles, none of them awarding lead, and is now a power jam as Ikonen has cut the track. Lead was still open when Billy Pistol got out of the pack, so it has been awarded to Tiger Bay. Let's see if she can get some points on the board. Firstly, coming into a tangle with number 14, Vatuvima. Penalties flying for the all colors. The first pass through was 5 points. Really needed for Tiger Bay. Absolutely no acknowledgement from the pack as she finishes her second scoring pass. That is a 10-point jam for the Tiger Bay Brawlers.
That is going to be the biggest jam for Tiger Bay so far. On the other side, Kallio have had two jams, putting up 14 points, and generally manage more passes. We've got a... Is this a penalty situation happening here? Yeah? Penalty assessed in the last minute.
Watching this replays. Yep. Huge hits from Kallio. I believe that was KO. Yeah. Living up to their name.
We've got penalty bingo on the Kallio side. And a team timeout?
Yes. For Kallio.
For Kallio. Yeah, this is probably a good time to take that timeout. The box is absolutely full. We've got four Kallio skaters in the box. That means what we're seeing on track right now is Vattuvimma alone against full complement of Tiger Bay blockers and jammers.
Could be, I'm going to call it good times.
Yeah?
But you decide if I'm being jokey or not.
Just being swarmed by the up on the middle completely surrounded.
And one blocker will be out of the box in under 10 seconds, though. So hopefully it's at the edge of that. So an unfortunate series of events leading up to this predicament. Well, it's not unfortunate if you're looking at it from the opposition of Tiger Bay. So...
This is the shot Tiger Bay has been looking for.
Yeah, absolutely. Tiger Bay at a 31-point deficit right now. Getting lead very quickly with only the one blocker on the track now. Joined by two and now joined by their jammer, Ikonen. Coming through, that is 5 points on the first scoring pass. Kallio losing once again, Vatuvima off to the box. And regaining KO. KO trying to be the last line of defense for Kallio, but Angie is gonna go ahead and make it through.
Yeah.
2 5-point passes and, oops, sorry, a 5-point and a 4-point. Whoop, okay, everything's a lie.
3 points for the last one.
I didn't mean to do this to you. You know what, the total's 12. The scoreboard went up and then it went down. Anyways, we're seeing a replay of Angie managing to bypass any opposition, doing a great job in that jam. 58-31 as we get under 12 minutes now. Jam is underway. Gilbert taking on Kid Block. We've seen some really exciting things from Kid Block in this game, especially.
Yeah, especially that defense, like that jammer to blocker switch that Kid Block is so adept at doing has been quite interesting.
She seems to sense when the opposing jammer is in, flip a switch when it's done. Mm. It's very nice to watch. So Kid Block now lead for Tiger Bay. Coming in on her first scoring pass. Gilbert would have met the back of the pack in time, once again called off. 2 more points on the board for the Tiger Bay Brawlers.
Box is completely empty. Magnificent sight. We just have just about 10 minutes of gameplay left. And we're sitting at 58 for Kallio versus 33 for Tiger Bay.
Yikarpov facing off against Steph Howarth. Yikarpov knocked out to the outside, is going to have to be recycled back. In the meantime, Steph Howarth up front facing off against this three brace that's doing a great job of essentially orbiting themselves. A bridge in place just in case. Ooh, and it's going to be Yikarpov finding their way out on the outside, picking up lead for Kallio.
Yeah, that's been it's been a while since Kallio had a lead. That's the three jams with no lead for Kallio. Mm-hmm.
Out of the pack and ready to score is Steph Howarth for Tiger Bay. Again called before she reaches the back of the pack and is going to be nothing picked up by Tiger Bay. Two more points for Kallio All Colors.
So once again, thank you for joining us here at WFTDA.TV. We still have one giant event here that you can watch. So get your watch pass for Champs, the 2018 International WFTDA Championships, and join us in 2 weeks.
Gilbert for Kallio, Billy Pistol for Tiger Bay. Again, the empty penalty box. Billy Pistol trying to crush through the pack. Gilbert getting knocked into the inside, being recycled back nearly to the jammer line. Billy Pistol up front, keeps being nearly through. Here we go, is through, but it's going to be Gilbert getting through. Okay, everything's a lie again. Billy Pistol did get lead. The jam refs, it was also so close for them that they had to communicate to each other and decide who had actually obtained this. Gilbert is in front, however, so it's going to have to be up to Billy Pistol whether or not she's going to call it in time or if she is aware of her bench's advice, because she's very close. Does end up calling it off after a few seconds. 3 points picked up by Tiger Bay, 2 picked up by Kallio, 62-36.
Would you look at that? Penalties are starting to even out on both teams, but we've had some from that penalty spiral we saw earlier on in the game to this sort of more controlled and clean.
Sure.
Both teams got their penalties cleaned up.
Yeah, I feel like maybe Tiger Bay had kind of spaced theirs out and Kallio was like, let's even out the penalties, but all in one jam.
Yeah. And I've just been informed by our lovely producer, Brom, that this is the very first jam where both teams have scored.
Nice.
If one team picks up points, the other one is held scoreless. But this is the first jam with both teams putting up points.
Nice.
So, what are we at here? 62 versus 36.
We're so close to a taco cat.
A taco cat?
I'm not asking for a lot here. It's a...
palindrome.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's easier to just call it a taco cat, though, isn't it?
I was wondering if you were referencing the person, Taco Cat.
No, but I'd also enjoy her.
So, 26 points separating these two teams.
Ikinen out for Kallio. Kid lock for Tiger Bay. Ikinen takes lead.
Where is Kid Block? Kid Block is still being held here going into turn two. Oh, beautiful dance around the Kallio blockers.
Little spin move there as Kid Block comes out. That was the end of her initial. She's going to be coming in for scoring just now. Ikinen, wholly aware of the situation. Guess what, though? Picked up 1 point. Taco Cat achieved.
There we go. Taco Cat achieved. I'm going to put this like on my achievements.
Yeah, it's like achievement unlocked, Taco Cat.
Yeah. Five minutes of this first half left.
Almost seven, really.
Oh. Wishful thinking.
Yikarpov out for Kallio, Steph Howarth out for Tiger Bay Brawlers. Steph Howarth at the top of the pack, but we've seen Karpov come out of nowhere before and take it over. It may be the case once again, because Steph is really having some trouble, joined by a teammate trying to help break it up. Just the defenses that both of these teams have come up with for this game. I mean, they're fighting for, this is the first of the semifinals, so of course you're expecting to see this sort of tenacity and power.
Yeah, definitely.
Karpov coming back, taking one more shot at that pack. We are almost a minute in, still no lead has been achieved. Pack having to reform on the floor straight away. Steph Howarth determined to get through with the help of Kemp, but just looks like the toughest situation.
Yi Karpo being drawn back a bit here, but another drawback. Steph Howard just the tenacity of just pushing and pushing and pushing for a minute and a half now. We've gone all the way almost across the track. We're at the second apex. No lead, nobody's budging.
All four of the Kallio blockers up front, making sure this is just not going to happen.
Dos Santos comes in to try and break up that Kallio defense. Unsuccessful. Everybody's recycled.
One Kallio blocker off in the box.
Lead in the last second. So Kallio did manage to nab lead right at the end, like 2 seconds before the jam was blown off. But lead was awarded. No points scored.
Sure.
So that was a 2 minute grind.
Yeah, definitely. Kid block out once again for Tiger Bay Brawlers. And Gilbert, of course, for Kallio. Lead awarded to Gilbert. Kid block still trying to smack up through that pack. There she goes, spinning again as she comes through those magnificent gold skates. Coming in on her first scoring pass, but Gilbert's going to go ahead and call it before any of that business happens. That is two more points for Kallio. Leaving Taco Cat for another day.
No more Taco Cat.
It's all right.
Did you notice Gilbert holding that as long as possible just to release the last blocker from the box?
Mm-hmm.
It's like not even trying to get through, just like facing the penalty box and waiting and waiting and waiting for the call off. We've got Ikonen going up against Angie. And that looks like a hole on the outside for Angie. She sees daylight is almost through, but caught in the Kallio defense up front. And this is going to be a power jam in favor of Kallio and Ikonen. Cut track penalty assessed to Angie. One power jam apiece for these teams.
All right, and lead has been awarded to Ikonen. The pack is a bit spread out. It's going to return to initial formation between the jammer and pivot line. Ikonen is going to come through, call it off. And that freezes Tiger Bay Brawler's jammer in the box for a very short power start. She is already stood out on the line. For Kallio is going to be Gilbert.
Oh, but look at that defensive work by Dos Santos up front, just keeping Ikonen. Dos Santos is a blocking machine.
Yeah,
it is.
Absolutely.
I love watching her play.
So this few seconds power start, I can see Angie is ready to get back on. Now released from the box. In the meantime, Gilbert up front. Lead now awarded with one last tag as they leave the pack. Now entering on their first scoring pass. The pack speeds up a bit as Angie comes through. Kallio trying to keep her from completing this initial. Knocked out to the outside by number 113, L, but There is no cut to be drawn. Angie would be coming on her first scoring pass and is now entered in scoring position in the meantime. Gilbert picking up the full four available points as she passes through the pack. Angie is through. That was also a four-point pass for the Tiger Bay Brawlers. Gilbert now in on their second scoring pass. Angie will shortly be in that same situation. A little bit of a scrum forming there for Angie.
It looks like Kallio is just running the clock on this one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what's happening. There's about 30 seconds left in the jam and about 10 seconds more than that left in the period. The bench is saying run it, run it, run it, and that is what's going on. So great defense holding Angie back for, I'd say, about half a minute just in this apex. All right, Angie manages to get through. That was the second scoring pass of 4 points. So an 8-8 jam as it comes to a close with 8 seconds left on the period clock. An official review has been called by Tiger Bay Brawlers, but I suspect it's being used as a timeout since the timing of it in the half, as well as I personally didn't see anything particularly out of place in this last jam. But
Tiger Bay using their official review as a timeout for this period.
Eddie Wizard with some information for you all. Yes, it was indeed just a timeout for Tiger Bay. Both teams are equal in terms of penalties, 7 apiece. 17 apiece, sorry. What have we got? We got a pretty good scoring streak going on, a lead streak for Kallio going on. Tiger Bay held scoreless for quite some time as well. And now we're going to go to the last jam of the half. Oh, we've got some Tiger Bay fans in the house here.
Ikarpov facing off against Kid Block for this final jam of the first period. The period clock now at zero. Ikarpov taking lead. Kid Block is out of the pack, about 30 feet behind Ikarpov. Ikarpov is now coming in on their first scoring pass. Pops into that pack and calls it off. So that was a 0-0 jam.
Once again. Beautiful work by both teams, but what we're seeing right now is Kallio dominating the game.
Certainly.
But Tiger Bay have got some really good moves, especially in particular with the eating of the baby, as they've successfully done both in this game and other times during this tournament. So we're going to come back in just about 14 minutes. So stay tuned.
We are back. If you're just joining us, you're going to be coming in for the second half of... Sorry, let me join the party. Kallio rolling rainbows, all colors, facing off against Tiger Bay Brawlers. We went into this half, Kallio 81, Tiger Bay 44.
Yes, indeed. Kallio are here to show us why they are the number one seed going into the tournament. Remember, winner of this game goes on to play the finals. Loser goes on to play third to fourth place. And those are going to be the last and the second to last games of today.
So this is our first semifinal here.
Mm-hmm. Up next, we have Dock City and Dublin facing off. But we still have a second half of this great game going on. So
our MC Roller Polar Bear getting the already riled crowd, pretty riled.
Yeah, it's a blast of sound right in front of us.
So you've got about 40 seconds. Did you notice anything interesting with the penalties in the first half?
Well, there are a lot of blocker penalties, not that many jammer penalties, but they seem to come in clusters. But as of last count, both teams are evenly distributed on penalties, so 17 apiece. Both teams have had one power jam each the previous half, so jammer penalties are not a thing. Not really a thing here.
So did you notice any trends, though, in the first half for the jammers or anything?
Well, our jammer stats are not really updating, so that's going to be hard to say.
I just wondered if you had any off-the-cuff observations that we can see if they hold true in this second half. Kid Block is out, taking lead very quickly for Tiger Bay. Gilbert still trying to get through, is now through. That was their initial completed. Kid Block on their first scoring pass picks up 4 points and calls it off.
Good show for Tiger Bay coming in from the halftime to put some points on the board. They had a bit of a dry run in the last half. Kallio had most of the leads, took most of the points, held Tiger Bay scoreless for several long streaks at a time.
Out on the line this time, we will be seeing Yi Karpov once again facing off against Angie. Angie trying to take to the outside. Not quite making it, getting knocked out by these all-color blockers. Recycled back behind number 234, Edgehog. Yi Karpov up at the front, facing off against all four of Tiger Bay's blockers.
Tiger Bay loses a blocker to the penalty box. That means Yi Karpov has one less defender to get across and shoots out of the pack to nab the lead.
That first scoring pass through was 5 points. Yi Karpov will be coming in on their second scoring pass now. Tiger Bay had two in the back waiting for them, but didn't quite work out as planned. 5 more points on this second scoring pass. Right now, a 10-point jam as they approach the century mark.
That's Wild with a drawback on Yi Karpov. We seem to have... Oh, there's Angie.
I lost her.
I lost Angie
for
a second.
I was
star in hand and just being smothered by Kallio defenders.
Coming in on this fourth scoring pass, Yi Karpov has already picked up 15 points. You can add another 5 to that right now. A 20-point jam, and we are in fact over that century mark as the jam comes to a close, 101-48.
So that saw Kallio go over the century, and this was also the highest scoring jam for Kallio this far. Based on what I have of jammer stats, I'm going to go ahead and say I think Yi Karpov is the main point scorer for Kallio so far.
I would definitely agree with that.
So that is going to be Tiger Bay's biggest threat.
Ikonen, speaking of threats, Ikonen, a time-tested and proven jammer out for Kallio, but it is going to be Billy Pistol taking lead for Tiger Bay. Ikonen through will be in scoring position in a fraction of a second. Tries to lob her way through, is knocked into the inside. It's going to recycle back at the same time. Billy Pistol recycling back, and a Kallio blocker headed off to the box. Pelipa still recycling back yet again. Her team just saying, I believe that's the run it.
Yeah. At this point of time, what Tiger Bay really wants to do is take up as much time as possible with lead to minimize the time that Kallio has lead, to minimize the Kallio control of the game that we've seen so far.
Sure. Well, speaking of control, they've already picked the four up. The bench of Tiger Bay signaling to go ahead and call it. I suspect there's 4 points already in that. Yes, indeed, a 4-4 jam. Kallio with 105, Tiger Bay at 52.
So do you know the symptoms of a concussion and the return to play protocol you and your teammates should be following? If you don't, then visit wftda.com/concussions for resources and information on the silent injury. We have Gilbert facing off against Kitlock on track, and it is going to be Kitlock who is out first to pick up lead. Gilbert recycled all the way past to the second turn.
Kitlock has control of it. It's going to have to decide if and when to call it off. Gilbert is through. That was the initial and the first pass through of Kitlock. 4 points, calling it off before Gilbert has time to pass anyone with their hips. It brings Tiger Bay Brawlers up to 56.
That means we are seeing a 49-point game. So Kallio is increasing their lead slowly but steadily.
Got that 5-second call out on the line. We're going to have Gilbert facing off against Billy Pistol. Gilbert up front is going to go ahead and take lead for Kallio. The pack is in between the pivot and jam line. Rejoining her teammates is Kemp. And it is a scoring pass, of course, for Gilbert, who's picked up all five. Billy Pistol still in the pack. 3 of Tiger Bay's blocker is not able to hold back Gilbert. Billy Pistol is now out. Gilbert goes ahead and calls it off as she was just a few feet in front of, or a few feet behind, I should say. The so opposition.
Yeah, so that's going to be 10 more points for Kallio, increasing their lead to 115 versus to Tiger Bay's 56. If you're just joining us, good morning. We're seeing Kallio playing in white, go up against Tiger Bay Brawlers in the black with orange accents. Kallio with a solid lead at 115 points, Tiger Bay sitting at 56. We've got Yi Karpov going up against Kitlock in this jam, and Yi Karpov is in the front, only has 2 defenders to beat, is recycled by the Tiger Bay pivot. And this is going to be a power jam for Kallio.
Yi Karpov taking lead. The pack still, once again, in between the jammer and pivot line. They are coming just around turn one now and at the top of the apex. Yi Karpov is just a few feet behind them as they speed up along the far straightaway and then make it to the second apex. As they approach the jammer line, Yi Karpov is sent off for a back block and is going to trade out with Kitlock. So it'll be probably about, it will be 20 plus seconds in the box as Kitlock was standing. She was released, now entering the pack, making quick time of it. That was the initial. So let's see how quickly she can get around and start picking up points. Of course, this is going to go the full 2 minutes, of which we have 43 seconds left. Yi Karpov now standing in the box.
Kitlock with a full scoring pass, 5 in the bag. Yes, sir.
Kid Block coming through now, as we've seen before, taking that offensive stance against Yekarpov. It was a 4-point pass for Kid Block, a 5-point pass for Yekarpov. Coming back to the pack. Both of these jammers are in scoring position. That is the natural conclusion of the jam.
And we have a timeout called by Tiger Bay.
See this replay of Karpov right before heading off to the box, and that is the jammer switch being replayed early on in that jam.
We are missing something.
Well, stop missing it then.
Yeah, so let's tell you all about our lovely officials for this game. Our non-skating officials are Gemma Track, Barney Trouble, Pretty Miffed, Princess Bitch, Alex, Misty Moan, Blind Yo, Sarah Wilkins, Lamish Tsitsi, Gorier Estefan, Saratonin, and Halo Jones.
And our skating officials today are Eddie Wizard, Righteous Oxide, Reflex, Feminist Killjoy, Direwolf, Slain, Shug's Bunny, and Chopsaw. So we are about to get back in action. Here we go. Ekinen facing off against Plant is going to be very quickly. Ekinen taking lead for Kallio. Plant is through, having completed her initial. Ekinen is in scoring position, getting muscled into the inside, calling it off right as she is mid-recycle. That is three more points for Kallio, 125-67.
20 minutes of gameplay left, but Kallio are still dominating this game. They're putting up more points. They're neutralizing the Tiger Bay jammers. They have more points put up per pass by far than Tiger Bay, which is what we're seeing reflected in the score.
Gilbert facing off against Kid Block. It's going to be Gilbert quickly through. Kid Block is really hung up in the back of the pack. Her teammates try to help break it up. Doesn't quite work out. A track cut is being assessed to Kid Block. In fact, has a seat in the box. This is now a power jam, and lead has, of course, been established prior to this scoring pass for Kallio.
And that is going to be a full box for Tiger Bay. Only one defender on track. We just had another blocker released. But for a moment there, single blocker out on track for Kallio. Gilbert made short work of that, put up full 5 points.
Multiplayer block being assessed now to Gilbert, which means we're going to go the full 2 minutes. It's not going to be a jammer switch because Kid Block had already served her entire penalty, so Gilbert will be sitting a new 30. So this will be the first scoring pass. Kallio had already completed 2 scoring passes before Gilbert headed off to the box. This is Kid Block's first through. The speed and momentum of that push through, picking up 5 points for Tiger Bay Brawlers, bring him up to 72, approaching the pack again at turn two.
Gets a little help from the pivot to get the Kallio pack moving.
We are now at a standstill on the apex as Gilbert, back in play, finishes that pass that they were last on, picks up 5, now a 15-point jam for Kallio. Coming in for the 4th scoring pass, Gilbert gets knocked out, and it is going to be a power start for Kallio as Kid Block had another seat in the box.
And that's 3 penalties in total for Kid Block, 2 of them just in this very jam we just saw.
So 17 8 minutes and 5 seconds left in the game. There is an official timeout being called. So what's this business about Champs VIP tickets, do you think?
Yeah, there is something about that, because apparently you can roll into Champs in New Orleans on November 9th to 11th in style with a 3-day VIP ticket for $150. And your VIP ticket gets you the only reserved seating in the venue and the best seats. You get a 2018 Championship Collectors Program. You get entrance for VIPs only, access to the VIP lounge, Sunday final countdown VIP party during the last game with complimentary drinks, and a VIP badge and lanyard. Limited quantities available, so go get your VIP tickets now at wftda.com/tickets.
Seeing a replay, a little bit of a collision there. Feminist Killjoy popping right back up. I believe that is the misconduct penalty that led to this power start. So Kid Block will be starting off in the box.
Yeah.
Did you not believe me?
No, I definitely believe you.
Okay.
I'm wondering whether or not that penalty could get upgraded.
I think that's what they're probably discussing right now.
Yes.
Because it makes sense.
Yes.
It would make sense for the discussion. I have no opinion on whether the call would make sense.
So, depending on what the ref crew agrees upon, what conclusion they come to, we might not see Kid Block for the remainder of the game. But let's await the actual calls by the referees before we go on and tell you anything more about that. And we've got the penalties on the overlay. As you can see, we've got, just from a visual check, it looks like Tiger Bay is slightly heavier on the penalties. With a few more skaters sitting on 5 and 4, penalties for Kallio are a bit more evenly distributed. But overall, not that many
not that many jammer penalties?
I was going to say not that many jammer penalties because I was... Well, if you count the first
The first half was
super clean.
Yes.
I think they had one jammer penalty apiece. Mm. But we had quite a few in these last couple of minutes, so...
Eddie Wizard and crew still discussing secret zebra things that will be shared with you in just a few seconds. And since it's not Kid Block in the box, what's happened?
Well,
what's happened? Eddie, you have to tell me the answers.
Yes.
Well, he doesn't have to. He has no real obligation to me, but
it would be very nice.
It would be cool.
To just
not time to speculate wildly.
Mm, don't leave us hanging here.
Oh, they're telling Braum. Oh, thank God.
Okay. Okay. So I've just been informed by our lovely producer Braum that it has been deemed that the contact was unavoidable. And the misconduct has been rescinded. So Kid Block has been released from the box and is back on the Tiger Bay bench. So don't worry, Kid Block fans. You will have another 16 minutes of Kid Block in your life.
It is Yikarpov with lead coming through. That was the first scoring pass, full 5 points. Angie is in jamming this time and not having completed her initial, getting some help hopefully from Wild to get her through. Yikarpov coming in, that second scoring pass right now. All right. Second scoring pass is completed. Another 5 points. So now a 10-point jam for Kallio. 153 to Tiger Bay's 74. Angie really... Oh, Angie passed the star. How's that? It is now Chant Hell.
OMG, that is the very first star pass in the entire game.
A 14-point jam for Kallio. This lead is well established. We have 15 and a half minutes left in the game.
And this is interesting, considering the fact that these teams are ranked three spaces from each other on WFTDA. This is a pretty wide lead for Kallio.
Definitely. Ikonen out for Kallio, Steph Howarth for Tiger Bay. It is going to be lead again to the All Colors. Ikonen will be coming in on their first scoring pass in just a few seconds. The pack is moving backwards towards the jammer line. Ikonen juking and blocking at the same time. Comes through having to get past Wild last. That is the full 5-point pass once again.
Penalties being assessed. That is going to be a penalty on Ikonen. Power jam for Tiger Bay. Where is Steph Howarth? Swarmed by Kallio defenders up front. There we go. Only has star in hand. Two left to beat. But that is KO with a takeout to the outside and a recycle.
Ikonen now standing in the box. Steph Howarth not quite capable of getting through this time. Ikonen now returning to play. Tiger Bay has defenses set up in the back that do prove useful. That is Wild doing a great job this jam. Steph Howarth recycled back behind number 14, Vatuvima.
And that was a great... Tiger Bay did not manage to capitalize at all on that Kallio... on that power jam.
Mm-hmm. On that Kallio jammer penalty. Didn't quite work out. The star has been passed to Tiger Bay. Now we're seeing some star passes to Thrill Collins. That is the end of that jam, though. 1 point picked up by Tiger Bay. Four more points picked up by Kallio. 167 to 75.
Oh.
Seeing that replay of Ikonen getting knocked into the inside and pulling herself back.
So if you are going to Champs, join the Derby community as we take over New Orleans for the first ever Champs Second Line Parade. Thursday, November 8th, wear to your team colors. Join in on the fun with the Big Easy Roller Girls at the Lagna Brass Band. The parade goes through the French Quarter, ends at a rocking after party at the Starlight Lounge. There are only 800 spots, so get in now by visiting wftda.com/champs and click to register for the parade.
It does sound amazing.
I think that's an experience you definitely want to get in on.
Yeah, definitely. If possible, do this thing in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Gilbert out for Kallio, Kid Block out for Tiger Bay. And Gilbert recycling back Kid Block, having a laugh about it as they do so. Now they're both into the pack. Kid Block knocked into the inside. Gilbert trying to go back once again. Going to head off to the box for a penalty, however, so lead is still open. Kid Block may achieve that. Or may get a forearms. It's,
jammer bump.
Fate's real weird.
Jammer bump, there we go. Tiger Bay have had 4 power jams. Kallio have had 3 power jams, so we're trading back and forth here.
All right. Gilbert fresh from the box. Getting out of the pack. That was initial. We have a minute on this jam. Kid Block now also in play. Coming up against these all colors.
Great footwork there by Gilbert.
Kid Block now swinging into that pack. Just having to find her way through the maze of humans.
We've got some more penalties being issued, and that's going to go to a Kallio blocker, number 2, Aika Helppo.
I feel like Gilbert's having just the best time in this jam. She's really smiley.
Yeah.
And,
even more than usual.
I know. It's like the happiest jam. Mm. A story by Gilbert. Finishing that up, Gilbert did pick up 13 points, so I would also be happy. 4 points picked up by Kid Block. 180 to 79, 101 point lead for Kallio. Under 11 minutes left in the game. We're seeing a replay of the last time I believe Gilbert tried to bring back Kid Block before the penalty was assessed. Karpov out for Kallio and Billy Pistol, and it's going to be Karpov taking lead, which often seems to be the case.
Yes, indeed. Karpov has the highest lead percentage, having picked up lead 9 out of 11 jams.
I'm not at all surprised by that statistic.
That's an 82 lead percentage.
Very nice. Now trying to come through 4 points. Going to be joined by number 19, Caddy Schrodinger. He's going to try to break up the defensive work of the opposition. Now we're just going to play this jam in reverse. Billy Pistol having a heck of a time in the back there. And that front three wall ready. The pivot is up front, trying to again help break up the defense. There's just so much action going on every jam in these packs that it's hard to use, you know, maybe some of the more traditional methods. You know, sending one blocker to break up the three isn't always proving as useful as it may have in the past.
No, Kallio is definitely expecting that to come, and they just filter and recycle and like reform. It's hard to chink that Kallio defense.
It's like an orbiting three brace. It's really a wonder to see. Karpov is through. That is the full 4 available points to them. Yeah. Billy Pistol still just having the hardest time getting through this jam, I think, has just decided to go ahead and block.
Yeah, with 2 Tiger Bay blockers in the box, that seemed like a the most viable decision at the time.
Seen some interesting jammer strategies towards that end from Tiger Bay, and I'm absolutely loving it. So see this replay, an interesting shot from the front of the pack as they move through. We have under 8.5 minutes left in the game. 188 to 83.
That's Ikonen taking on Kid Block. Oh, Dos Santos up in front, trying to create some space for Kid Block. And it does work.
Yeah, so Kid Block does have lead for Tiger Bay.
That's the first one in a while for Tiger Bay. The first lead in quite a while.
Out of the pack is Ikonen, and not terribly far away, so that is going to be called pretty quickly into the pack, but not so quickly that all 4 points are not accrued. So 4 more points to Tiger Bay, nothing picked up that time for Kallio, 188 to 87.
There we go. Speaking of Kid Block and Kid Block has been We finally got our jammer stats working again, and it proved, like, I got numbers on what I expected, which is that Kitlock is the highest scoring jammer for Tiger Bay, and has also played by far the most jams. 12 jams in total as jammer for Kitlock.
Angie out for Tiger Bay, Gilbert out for Kallio, and neither of them able yet to get through. Angie being recycled all the way back to the jammer line, and now so is Gilbert.
Yeah, that Kallio defense has Angie's number. It's just also an impressive, I mean, the Kallio defense is like twice the size, all of them are twice the size of Angie.
A forearms being assessed to one of the Tiger Bay Brawlers is going to match how many blockers are in the box, as Edgehog is also seated for Kallio. Angie still trying to press through this front two brace, does make it, lead again to Tiger Bay. Let's see if we can get some points on the board, shore up the score just a little bit as we while away this second half. Pack stood around the edge of the straightaway by turn two. Angie is pressing. The back is heavily guarded by Kallio all colors.
Sarah Gilbert just not getting past those last two blockers up front. That's Dos Santos and Chantel just containing Gilbert.
Angie's going to go ahead and call it off. Let's see what got picked up. That was the 4 points for Tiger Bay. Nothing picked up by the All Colors. 188 to 91. 5:22 left in the game. We're seeing a replay of Angie getting bounced forward, honestly, by the opposition.
We've got Kuti going up against Kid Block. There we go. Kallio using the last couple of minutes and their comfortable lead to give their relief jammer some game time and some experience in tournament.
Attila Lahan sitting in the box for Tiger Bay. And it's going to be a power jam for Tiger Bay as Kuti is headed to the box. Lead still open now, achieved by Kid Block. The pack is scooting back to turn two. Now on the far straightaway, nearly through the front of the pack. Getting knocked out to the outside, gonna have to come back behind a couple of these blockers. Having to press now against this now famous three wall up front. All four of the blockers honestly concentrated on her. Number 271, Peb, trying to help out with that situation. But once you knock one out, another one comes right back in.
We've got an attempted star pass. No, it's going to be a star stash. Did not succeed in passing. There's the pass.
So that pass went to L, pivot extraordinaire. And having a seat in the box is Kid Block. So this will be the full 2 minutes right now, a power jam for Kallio.
We've only got a couple of seconds left on the clock, so this looks like it might also be a power start for Kallio. Tiger Bay, a jammer and two blockers in the box, so clean box on Kallio's side. Pack advantage to Kallio. And this is the thing, Tiger Bay is starting to accrue quite a lot of penalties. We have had a foul out on Tiger Bay's side. We have three blockers sitting at 6 penalties. So that is going to be that's a stark contrast to the Kallio side, where, yeah, you have some penalties, but not even close the number. An official review has been called by Tiger Bay.
So Eddie Wizard will be attending to that and hopefully back to us in just a few seconds.
Here we go.
Tiger Bay are using their official review for the second period. They're requesting a penalty be issued to the Kallio jammer for touching their jammer helmet cover while it was on the track.
So there you have it. No touching.
Tiger Bay don't want any touching.
Yeah, you know.
So if you have anything else to say to us today for this game, for the rest of the tournament, tweet us at #talk2 with the numeral 2, WFTDA. Up next, we have Dock City versus Dublin. Winner will go on to play the final against probably Kallio. Loser will go on to play the third to fourth place against what looks like to be Tiger Bay. So tune in for that later today. And we got a verdict.
After review, no call will be made, as any contact to Tiger Bay's helmet cover only made the track safer, and there was no impact on recovery of the star. Thank you.
Eddie Wizard has spoken. The no call stands. And we get 5 seconds to derby.
Gilbert out on the line. Kid Block still sitting in the box. So Gilbert is going to take lead for Kallio. The pack just on the far straightaway, only barely though.
Kid Block is out of the box. Mm-hmm. Comes in with cover in hand, dances through, and is out.
Free hugs.
I've got to say, both Kid Block and Gilbert have been putting on some great showmanship here today.
MVPs of my heart.
And if you've been enjoying the Sarah Gilbert showmanship, please do enjoy a little bit longer. This is going to be the second to last game for Sarah Gilbert. So, Gilbert will be retiring after this tournament, so enjoy that showmanship while you can.
I will. Laura Punkkonen out for the first time in this game. Steph Howarth out for several times.
About 8 times, yeah.
Let's say 8, yeah. I feel good about that number. Punkkonen trying to find their way along the outside. Looks like it may work out, yeah. Passing lastly, number 15, Dos Santos. Lead is awarded once again to all colors. The Baby Shark song is started in the crowd. Not super sure. I'm not clear on why or when people sing that, but it seems to be like a thing. There was not enough time going to be left on the clock for a final jam, so a timeout is taken by the All Colors, who are now at the 200-point mark, having picked up 5 points in that last jam. So we will have one more jam coming here in a minute. Mm.
And it seems like Kallio is using their 104-point advantage to just get their jammer roster, their less experienced jammer roster, some more game time.
Sure.
We've seen a steady rotation of Jay Karpov, Gilbert, and Ikonen all throughout the game. Aww.
Group aww.
And that's the thing, though. It's been a fierce and competitive game, but it still feels like everybody's really nice to each other. There's a smiles all around. That's Kid Block on the line for Tiger Bay, going up against Koti for Kallio. So as predicted, one more jam to give the jammers some more experience. And Kid Block is your lead jammer.
Ooh, Koti getting knocked into the inside, recycling back. Tiger Bay's bench saying, run it, run it, run it, run it, run it. And that we will right now, a 5 point pass for Kid Block, bringing Tiger Bay over the 100 point mark. We have a minute 22 left available in the game as the period clock has expired. Kid Block now against this defensive tripod, of course.
That's KO Batuvima, and I believe Edgehog.
And that is another 4 point pass.
Open outside for pivot turn jammer L.
Yes, there has been a star pass and 4 points picked up right now by Kallio.
And that is a power jam for Kallio. Kid Block in the box. For a back block penalty. And the pack's just running away.
Yep. Time for fast back.
Oh.
Ooh. All right, that is the end of the jam, the end of the game, the unofficial final, 209 for Kallio, All Colors, and, oops, sorry,
yep,
214 to Tiger Bay Brawlers, 106.
So there you have it. Kallio advances to play the final, and that's going to be at 5:30 tonight local time. They're going to be playing against the winner of this next day games. That's going to be Dock City or Dublin.